In middle school parliamentary debate, the topic you'll be debating is called the resolution. For example, the resolution in your debate might be ban school uniforms. There are two teams, each with three debaters. The team that is arguing for the resolution is called the proposition team. The team that's arguing against the resolution is called the opposition team. Each team has three debaters, and each debater delivers one speech. The order is as follows. The first proposition speaker speaks first for 5 minutes. As the first proposition speaker, you'll introduce yourself, give a definition of terms if applicable, give a plan if applicable, and then present three or four major points for the resolution backed by evidence. The first opposition speaker speaks next, also for 5 minutes. As the first opposition speaker, you'll introduce yourself, give a counter plan if applicable. You'll then refute the proposition's major points, and finally, present three or four arguments against the resolution backed by evidence. The second proposition speaker then speaks for 5 minutes. As the second proposition speaker, you should rebuild and extend upon the original points brought up by the first proposition speaker, and you should refute the opposition's major arguments against the resolution. If time permits, you may introduce additional arguments for the resolution backed by evidence. The second opposition speaker then speaks for 5 minutes. As the second opposition speaker, you should extend and amplify the opposition team's arguments against the resolution, providing new evidence or information about why the opposition team should win the debate. If time permits, you may introduce additional arguments against the resolution backed by evidence. The third opposition speaker then speaks for 5 minutes. As the third opposition speaker, you should put the entire debate together and explain why your side should win the debate. This is your team's final opportunity to refute the proposition team's arguments and restate your team's arguments. No new arguments are permitted in the third opposition speech. The third proposition speaker then speaks for 5 minutes. As the final speaker in the debate, you should explain why your side should win the debate. This is your team's final opportunity to refute the opposition team's arguments and restate your team's arguments. No new arguments are permitted in the third proposition speech. There are two other important features of middle school parliamentary debate: points of information, or POI. A POI is a request made by a member of the non-speaking team to the speaker to yield time to make a statement or ask a question. POIs may be attempted only during the first four constructive speeches of a debate. POIs may be attempted only after the first minute and before the last minute of an opponent's speech. The first minute and last minute of constructive speeches are referred to as protected time, and no POIs are allowed. A debater attempts a POI by standing, or by standing and saying POI, or by saying point of information. The speaker may then accept or reject the POI. If the speaker accepts a POI, an opponent has up to 15 seconds to deliver the POI. Heckling. This is a respectful interruption during an opponent's speech by saying one or two words. The key here is that heckles are meant to add substance to the debate, not to distract or harass the speaker. Heckles may be made at any time and during any speech. An example of a good heckle is as follows. Imagine if the resolution is that Puerto Rico should be made the 51st state. If the opposition speaker argues that no island has ever become a U.S. state, a member of the proposition team could heckle by saying, Hawaii? The key to heckling is to remember that a heckle should add substance to the debate, not interfere with a speaker's ability to deliver a speech. There you have it. These are the middle school parliamentary debate rules in a nutshell. Finally, when the debate is over, make sure you thank your judge.